Right guys, welcome back to the channel, welcome back to another video. In this one I'm just going to be showing you how to install a new SRAM 11 speed chain onto your road bike. So let's go ahead, let's take a look.
So here we have the chain 11 speed, which is the SRAM. This is a PC1170 chain on here. Now, I'll just show you what to look out for on this. Obviously it's always worth checking your chain from time to time just to see how badly it is worn. Now being this 11 speed chain, it's basically 0.5 any more than that on a chain gauge and the chain's scrap, so it needs changing. Otherwise all you're going to do is wear out your rear cassette and your front chain rings unnecessarily if the chain's badly worn, so it's always worth checking it. Now this particular chain is in desperate need of replacing. This is just a cheap chain tool here, and it's even on the most worn, like I said, if it's an 11 speed chain it'd be like 0.50, and this is one on here, and that would just drop straight in there with that much spare. So is completely worn out. And another way to tell how badly this chain is stretched, I'll show you against a brand new chain here, exactly the same chain but new. Before I change it, what I'll do is I'll shift down. You'll see we're on the inner at the front there. If I shift down to the 11 at the back on the rear, I'll just show you something else. So we got it shifted down to the 11 there at the back. Now if you look, the chain is making contact there with the cage, so it's back on itself just there, so it should be, obviously, here, so it's not making contact when it's in the inner chain ring and the 11 at the back. There should be some tension on that cage there to keep that chain away from touching there. So as you can see, it's stretched so much it's lost its tension. So if I pull that cage round there, you see that there, it's been like it so long that it's worn a groove in the actual derailleur there. So where it's been rubbing there, it's worn that away, the metal. So it's in, like I said, dire need of changing. So what I'll do is get this one off and we'll put a new one on. So most modern bikes these days have got a quick link, master link, in the chain, so it's not riveted together, so you can take it off easily for maintenance, etc. So all you do is get your pliers in there, either side of it, like that, and just squeeze it together. Just hold either side of the chain at the same time, like that. And there you've got your two halves there. So always replace these with the brand new ones as well when you're doing the chain. So they should come with the chain. If they don't, then you can buy them separately as well. Let's get the right ones for your chain. So remove this one off of here and we'll get a new one to length, and I'll just show you them side by side so you can see how much that it's actually worn. So we've led the chains next to one another and just lined them up on the end just so you can see. So the new one is closest here, and that's the used one there that I've just taken off. So if you see, as it gets along here, it starts going along, you see how it, by there, it's already, this is a new one, that's the used one. So you can see how far that's out already, just in that distance there, it's already started to go out that much already. So you imagine over the length of the chain how far it's out. So see, what you need to do, just count the links of the old chain, and then we'll put it against the new one before we cut the new chain down size. So here we have the chains again. So I've got the new one on the far side this time, and here's the used one that come off it. So the same amount of links along the chain. By counting them, the chain needs to be cut there, and that's the same amount of links. So you can see how far that's stretched. So that's the one we need to cut out there to make it the same length as this existing one. So that chain has grown that much in length, hence why the derailleur at the back is back on itself and the chain's rubbing against the cage there, because it's grown that far from when it was new. That's how worn it is. So we're going to cut it there. So now we know where we need to cut the chain to size, then get your chain breaker there. So we'll just put this in. Like so. And then make sure that it's lined up with the pin there that you want to push out. So once you're happy it's in the right place, you can carry on and push the pin out through there. Initially get it going like that. Obviously you need the correct tool here to push out the size of the pin. You don't want it too big, otherwise it's going to get jammed in the chain as it goes through and damage to your new chain. You just push that on through like that. You see that or not? Just wind that out like that. So it's just come out just there. And all we do is back the tool off. And there we have it. What we'll do is we go ahead and get this back on the bike. Obviously what you need for using the master link like that, you need two ends. They're the same, like this. So the male ends on the of the chain. So you can go ahead and use your link like that on both sides. So that's how you know you've cut it down correctly. If you was riveting the chain together, then obviously you'd need a male and a female end left. But when you're using one of these quick links, master links, you need two male ends like that. So you got the chain back on, riveted through the derailleur correctly. And you just want to put your one link there on one side, and then one on the opposite side there. And then, so you bring the chain together like that. You clip that together. Then you can use your tool to put it back together again. Make sure that on these there's an arrow there. Make sure the arrow is going in the direction of travel. So on the bottom, the arrow will be pointing backwards. And then on the top, it'll be pointing forwards towards the front chain rings. So make sure that arrow is the right place there. Then you can just clip it together with your tool if you want to, like that. Or you can put that link at the top here, at the top. And then what you do is, with that link at the top to get it to go together, just push down on your crank arm with your foot, and that link will just go together at the top. If you want to do that, or just use your tool on it. So already you can see, I'll just move the camera, but already you can see there that now it's cut and it's a new chain. It's not anywhere near touching. So there you go. Now it's nowhere near touching on there like it was before. That was tight against there. Now it's cut to the same length as it was before exactly, but now because it's new, it's nowhere near touching that. So obviously you see me put a new chain on there. What one thing to bear in mind also is if your chain is badly worn like that and you don't know the age of your cassette on the rear, then if you put a new chain on a worn cassette, they're not going to work properly together. So when you start pedaling, you wonder why it's suddenly skipping. As soon as you load up with a bit of power on the pedals, it will just be skipping all the time, the chain, because it's not matching up to the obviously the badly worn cassette. So if you don't know the age of the cassette, then it's always worth changing the chain and the cassette at the same time.
So if you found the video helpful, remember to give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel for more cycle related content. Till next one, ride safe and I'll see you then.